Hello students, we are back here to study probability. In the previous session, we people had studied about different activities that were explained to us. In the activities, one activity was tossing a coin several number of times, and then after that in a group the same activity. And we also studied what is a trial, or we also studied the activity of throwing a die. At the end of the previous session, we studied what is a trial and what is what else we had studied. Yeah, every time whatever experiment we are doing, whatever action we are performing, it is known as trial, and outcome is whatever we are getting as an result of that experiment. So if proceeding further, at the end of the last session I was explaining you that in activity 1, each toss of a coin is called a trial. Similarly, in activity 3, each throw of a die is a trial, and each simultaneous toss of two coins in activity 4 is also a trial. So a trial is an action which results in one or more several outcomes. The possible outcomes in activity 1 were head and tail, whereas in activity 3 the possible outcomes were 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. In activity 1, the getting of a head in a particular throw is an event with outcome head. Similarly, getting a tail is an event with outcome tail. Till here we had studied. Now we shall proceed further. In activity 2, the getting of a particular number, say 1, is an event with outcome 1. What they are saying, in activity 2, the getting of a particular number, say 1, is an event with outcome 1. If our experiment was to throw the die for getting an even number, then the event consists of 3 outcomes, namely 2, 4 and 6. So further they are explaining us that if our experiment was to throw the die for getting an even number, what they are saying, to throw the die for getting an even number, then the event would consist of 3 outcomes, namely 2, 4 and 6. So an event for an experiment is the collection of some outcomes of the experiment. So what is an event? An event for an experiment is the collection of some outcomes of the experiment. In class 10, you will study a more formal definition of an event. In class 10, you will study a more formal definition. So, can you now tell what the events are in activity 4? With this background, let us now see what probability is. Based on what we directly observe as the outcomes of our trials, we find the experimental or empirical probability. What they have said, that you just find out what are the activities in, what are the events in activity 4, and with this background, now what we are going to study, now let us see probability. And what it is based on, what we directly observe as the outcomes of our trials, we find the experimental or empirical probability. Let n be the number of trials. The empirical probability P of E of an event, what is E? Of an event E. E is the event. happening is given by, and what is an event, it has been explained here. An event for an experiment is the collection of some outcomes of the experiment. So P of E is equals to number of trials in which the event happened and the total number of trials. What is P of E or empirical probability? It is number of trials in which the event happened upon the total number of trials. In this chapter, we shall be finding the empirical probability, though we will write probability for convenience. Instead of empirical probability, we will be writing, for the convenience, it is written as probability only. Let us consider some examples. To start with, let us go back to activity 2 and table 15.2. In column 4 of this table, what is the fraction that you calculated? Nothing, but it is the empirical probability of getting a head. What they are saying? Activity 2, 15.2 table number and column 4. Let us go to the previous page. Here you can see they are talking of column 4. What are the fractions here? Cumulative number of tails upon total number of times the coin is tossed. Coin is tossed. Okay, what are these fractions? Previously we have studied what these fractions are, and what they are telling regarding this, these fractions are nothing but the, what they are telling, these fractions are nothing but, it is the empirical probability. Those fractions, whatever were there, no, those were nothing but the empirical probability of getting a head. Note that this probability kept changing depending on the number of trials and the number of heads obtained in these trials. Similarly, the empirical probability of getting a tail in column 5 of the same table, that is 15.2, this is 12 upon 15 to start with, then it is 2 upon 3, then 28 upon 45, and so on. So the empirical probability depends on the number of trials taken and the number of times the outcomes you are looking for coming up in these trials. See what they are saying. The empirical probability depends on the number of trials undertaken and the number of times the outcomes you are looking for coming up in these trials. Okay. Activity 5. Let us see what they are explaining us in activity 5. Before going further, look at the tables you drew up while going activity, while doing, sorry, instead of saying doing, I am saying going. While doing activity 3, find the probabilities of getting a 3 when throwing a die a certain number of times. What they are saying? They are saying of activity 3, find, what is activity 3? That you are throwing a die. So find the probabilities of getting a 3 when throwing a die a certain number of times. Also show how it changes as the number of trial increases. Now let us consider some other examples. Okay, apart from the activities, now some examples they are going to explain. A coin is tossed 1000 times with the following frequencies: head 455, tail 545 times. What has happened? A coin is tossed 1000 times, and what are the frequencies of getting head and tail? 455 times head turned up and tail turned up 545 times. Compute the probability for each event. Calculate it. What is the probability for each event? Since the coin is tossed 1000 times, the total number of trials is 1000. Let us call the events of getting a head. Let us call the events of getting a head and of getting a tail as E and F respectively. Means what? E is the event for getting head and F is the event for getting tail in the same sequence. The sequence is not changing. Then the number of times E happens, that is the number of times a head come up, is 455. So the probability of E is equals to number of heads upon total number of trials. That is P of E is equals to 455 upon 1000 is equals to 0.455. Similarly, the probability of the event of getting a tail is equals to number of tails upon total number of trials. P of F is equals to 545 upon 1000 is equals to 0.545. Note that in the example above, P of E plus P of F is equals to 0.455 plus 0.545 is equals to 1. And E and F are the only two possible outcomes of each trial. Yes. A coin we are tossing, so we will get either head or tail, no other possibility is there. So E and F are the only two possible outcomes of each trial. And what we got? P of E plus P of F is equals to 1. Let us see the next example. Two coins are tossed simultaneously 500 times. Understand carefully, two coins are tossed 500 times simultaneously. We get two heads 105 times, one head 275 times, no head 120 times. See the frequencies that have been recorded. Two heads 105 times, one head 275 times, no head 120 times. Find the probability of occurrence of each of these events. Solution. What they are explaining us here in the solution? Let us denote the events of getting two heads, one head and no head by E1, E2 and E3 respectively. Means what? E1 is for the event for what? Getting two heads. E2 is denoted for the event getting one head and E3 is denoted for the event what it is? No head. Yeah. So probability of E1, P of E1 is equals to 105 upon 500 is 0.21. P of E2, 275 upon 500 is equals to 0.55 and P of E3 is equals to 120 upon 500 is equals to 0.24. I hope you people know how to calculate this. Observe that P of E1 plus P of E2 plus P of E3 is equals to 1. Also, E1, E2 and E3 cover all the outcomes of a trial. What they are explaining? That P of E1 plus P of E2 plus P of E3 is equals to 1. Also, E1, E2 and E3 cover all the outcomes of the trial. I'll do one thing. I'll show you one calculation here. Let us do this calculation, that is 500. We are dividing 105 by 500. So what happens now? 105 is smaller than 500. We cannot divide it. So it is 500 zeros. It is 0. Again, as it is 105, I am giving a decimal point here. I can give a 0 after the decimal point. So 500 twos are, I get 1000. What is remaining now? 50. One more 0 I am taking. 50 is smaller than. Now 500 ones are 500. I hope the concept is clear. How you got 0.21? How you got 0.21? Now we shall add all the things as it has been just now mentioned to us. 0.21 plus 0.55 plus 0.24. All the probabilities we are adding, it is 21, 5 plus 1, 6, 6 plus 4, 10, carry 1, 2 plus 1, 3, 5 plus 3, 8, 8 plus 2, 10, carry 1, and here 1 plus 0 plus 0, it is 1. What is explained here? Please see. Here you can see it has been explained to us that observe that P of E1 plus P of E2 plus P of E3 is equals to 1. You can see the calculation here. Also, E1, E2 and E3 cover all the outcomes of a trial. I think you must have understood this concept. Proceeding further. Example 3. A die is thrown 1000 times with the frequencies for the outcomes 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6 as given in the following table. The table is giving the frequencies of the outcomes of 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. See the frequencies. 1 out for 1, 179, for 2, 150, for 3, 157. For 4, 149, for 5, 175 and for 6, 190. Find the probability of getting each outcome. Find the probability of getting each outcome. Let E of I denote the event of getting the outcome I, where I is equals to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Then probability of outcome 1, that is P of E1, is equals to frequency of 1 upon total number of times the die is thrown. 179 upon 1000 is equals to 0.179. Similarly, P of E2 is equals to 150 upon 1000 is 0.15. P of E3 is equals to 157 upon 1000 is equals to 0.157. P of E4 is equals to 149 upon 1000 is equals to 0.149. P of E5, 175 upon 1000 is equals to 0.175. And P of E6 is equals to 190 upon 1000 is 0.19. After adding, note that P of E1 plus P of E2 plus P of E3 plus P of E4 plus P of E5 plus P of E6. What is the answer? We are getting 1. Also note that the probability of each event lies between 0 and 1. What? the probability of each event lies between 0 and 1. The sum of all probabilities is 1. The sum of all probabilities is 1. E1, E2 to E6 cover all the possible outcomes of a trial. These events, that is outcome as 1, 2 and so on, 6, cover all the possible outcomes of a trial. Let us go for the next example. On one page of a telephone directory, there were 200 telephone numbers. The frequency distribution of their unit place digit, for example, what the example is, on a page of a telephone directory, there were 200 telephone numbers. The frequency distribution of their unit place of the telephone numbers, the frequency distribution of that, that is the digit on the unit's place. For example, in the number 25828573, the unit's place digit is 3. They are talking of this value, this digit, not value, this digit, and is given in table 15.7. Let us check. Digit 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. And frequency in ones place of this particular digit 22, 26, 22, 22, 20, 10, 14, 28, 16, 20. Without looking at the page, the pencil is placed on one of these numbers. That is, the number is chosen at random. What is the probability that the digit in its units place is 6? What they are saying? Without looking at the page, the pencil is placed on one of these numbers. That is, the number is chosen at random. So, what it means? The number is chosen at random. So, what is the probability that the digit in its units place is 6? So, what is the event here? Probability that the digit in its units place is 6. The probability of digit 6 being in the units place is what? Frequency of 6. Is what? Frequency of 6 upon total number of selected telephone numbers. Now here you can see the frequency of 6 is 14 and the total number of selected telephone numbers are 200. Because on a page they are mentioning that there are 200 telephone numbers of a telephone directory. So what is the answer here? The answer is 0.07. You can similarly obtain the empirical probabilities of the occurrence of the numbers. What you can do? You can similarly obtain the empirical probabilities of the occurrence of the numbers having other digits in units place. Similarly, you can find out the probabilities of the other numbers. Example 5. The record of a weather station shows that out of past 250 consecutive days, consecutive means one after another, its weather forecasts were correct 175 times. What the record of a weather station, what it is showing, that out of past 250 consecutive days, continuous 250 days, previous means past, its weather forecasts were correct 175 times. Means whatever the weather station predicted for 250 days, out of that 175 times, for 175 days it was correct. What is the probability that on a given day it was correct? And second thing, what is the probability that it was not correct on a given day? Okay, the very first thing, the total number of days, the total number of days for which the record is available is 250. Probability of the forecast was correct on a given day. So, number of days when the forecast was correct upon total number of days for which the record is available. Number of days when the forecast was correct is 175 days. Total number of days by which the record is, for which the record is available is 250. So, we are getting 0.7. We are getting 0.7. Agreed? Second, the number of days when the forecast was not correct is what? 250 minus 175 is equals to 75. So, probability of what? The forecast was not correct on a given day is how much? 75 upon 250 is equals to 0.3. Notice that probability of forecast was correct on a given day plus probability of forecast was not correct on a given day is equals to 0.7 plus 0.3 is equals to 1. Next example, a tire manufacturing company kept a record of the distance covered before a tire needed to be replaced. The table shows the results of 1000 cases. What the table is showing? It is showing the results of 1000 cases. Distance in kilometer is the first row and frequency is the second row. First column, less than 4000 kilometers, frequency is 20 tires were replaced. 4000 to 9000 kilometers, frequency is 210 tires were replaced. 9001 to 14000, 325 tires were replaced. And more than 14000, 445 tires were replaced. If you buy a tire of this company, what is the probability that it will need to be replaced before it has covered 4000 kilometers? It will last more than 9000 kilometers. It will need to be replaced after it has covered somewhere between 4000 kilometers and 14000 kilometers. See what the questions are. What is the probability that it will need to be replaced before it has covered 4000 kilometers? It will last more than 9000 kilometers. It will need to be replaced after it has covered somewhere between 4000 kilometer and 14000 kilometer. You can see here, the total number of trials are 1000. Today we shall conclude the session here. I think you people have understood the question. The solution or the remaining part we shall see in the next session. In this session, we have studied how exactly the events are happening and what is the probability. Concluding this session here, I suggest you people to study regularly and properly and take care of yourselves. Thank you.